There are many ways to attract wildlife to a piece of land. Some hunters use corn feeders to draw whitetails into a small area near a deer stand. Food plots are a popular method of attracting animals for harvest, and if managed properly, they can also provide a natural supplemental food source.
You've got to discern, okay, do I want to harvest or take pictures or view animals, or do I want to provide for them?
If the goal is providing supplemental wildlife food, corn probably isn't the best option.
With corn, there's a lot of issues with diseases. There's aflatoxin fungus that gets on the corn. That's deadly to turkeys. It increases predation rates. Corn might attract and protein pellets may have a lot of protein in them. For your money, you can get a lot more protein available out of food plots. And a deer is actually going to utilize up to 60% of their diet in food plots, because to them that is a natural food. It's naturally available. It's not artificial like a supplemental feed.
When planting food plots, there are many considerations. The first is a soil test.
The most important thing on your soil sample is to get a good representative sample of the whole area. So take some samples, three or four or five samples from your food plot area, mix all that together, then take a 1 pint subsample of that and bring it down to the extension office and we'll get it sent off for you.
The test results will determine the amount of lime needed to adjust the soil's pH level.
It's important that you get the lime out ahead of time. It takes 3 to 6 months to properly adjust the soil pH.
Soil testing also will dictate the type and amount of fertilizer to apply for specific crops. The next consideration is the size and shape of the plots. If a food plot's goal is attracting deer to a location, more so than providing supplemental food, think small.
A good harvest plot is about 1.5 acres or less.
Beyond simply attracting deer, food plots can provide supplemental food. But to benefit deer in the long term, land managers need to plant at least 10% of their acreage in year-round food plots. The average food plot costs $300 an acre, so a 1,000-acre property would need to plant 100 acres at a cost of roughly $30,000. A more cost-effective alternative that's also better for wildlife is simple habitat management.
The best thing you can do for most properties is to go out and do some kind of habitat management, timber thinning. We always recommend prescribed burning after you've done a timber thinning. The main reason for that is if it's not open enough, the prescribed burn will burn off the litter, but you won't get the sunlight on the ground and get the regrowth to produce that free food plot that you can get through a prescribed fire.
The Arkansas Game and Fish Commission's Private Lands Program helps landowners achieve their management goals. 9 private lands biologists cover the state. They consult with landowners, help arrange funding through conservation programs, and provide technical assistance.
Whatever your goals are, the job of a private lands biologist in Arkansas is to go out, look at your property, evaluate what you have on the ground, what are your goals, and then give you a plan to get from where you are to where you want to be.
No matter where you want to be, it all starts and ends with good wildlife habitat.